from Amsterdam. My name is Vanna. Usually I make travel vlogs, but today I'm going to show you around one of the oldest neighborhoods in Amsterdam. Currently I'm walking at the Stadhouderskade, one of the main roads in the city center, and we're walking towards the Heineken Experience, where we'll start this walking tour. First things first, how to get to the neighborhood De Pijp. Over there you see the light trail, so you can take 16 or 24 from Central Station and get out here. So this is Weteringschans, that's what the stop is called. And when you turn around, you will see the Heineken brewery. So the famous Dutch beer brand Heineken. I think this is the old brewery. I'm not sure if they still brew the beer here, but if somebody knows, let me know down in the comments below. But at least you can get like the Heineken Experience over here. And we are going to continue over there because this is where the Pijp starts. Now, before you even start thinking about crossing to the other side, the Asian way, like ignoring red traffic lights and everything, don't. This is one of the most dangerous intersections in Amsterdam. Seriously, people have died here because of ignoring traffic lights. Don't do that. Watch the traffic lights over here. Okay. I have never seen this, coach and horses. But apparently we have coach and horses in Amsterdam. This is the Stadhouderskade, by the way. It's a main road all around the city center. And we are going to wait for the green traffic lights. What are these horses, man? Interesting. There we go, green traffic lights. Also a Dutch fire truck, in case you're interested. Should I go, should I not? Oh, no. No, you should not go. This is why. You don't see the cars coming. Do not cross this traffic light if the light is not green. See, this is what I mean. The cars are driving. No, don't get killed in Amsterdam. Yes, it's green. Someone who once made a joke, I think it's an old teacher of mine, that in Amsterdam you can die 5 times crossing the street. So once because of the bikes, then again because of the cars, light rail is usually like in the middle, cars again, bikes again. So yeah, be careful. We're going to continue this way. Ferdinand Bolstraat. Now I'm only going to show you the most important parts from the neighborhood De Pijp, because it's quite a big neighborhood and most of the action happens at the places that I'm going to show you. Unfortunately they're doing construction right now, so it doesn't look that pretty, but trust me, when they're finished it will be very, very pretty. On our left we have a really good Indian restaurant. It is called the Taj Mahal, if I'm correct. Yes, Taj. I really like it. And this is Marie Heinekenplein. So over here in summer it's completely packed because they have like these terraces. In summer this is a really, really cool place to visit, but also in winter because there are lots of good restaurants. And at Barça you can have really good tapas, so small bites, it's like Spanish, and you can also party over there. But we are going to continue straight ahead towards Albert Cuyp. To be very, very fair, I usually go to clubs when I want to party, but for a lot of Amsterdam or Dutch people, a party is really a good party when you go to a bar and just have a drink and yada yada. I don't do that often because I really like to dance, not just sit at a bar and have drinks sometimes, but not all the time. So, but yeah, if you want to go to a bar, Marie Heinekenplein is really cool. You have two bars over here as well. One over here and one over here. But we are going to turn right because I want to show you a really, really cool cake shop. And unfortunately, I cannot cross the street over here. So we are just going to go back a little bit. Over here is also a really cool, well, if you have a dress-up party, you can get your stuff over here. They have cool stuff. Look at that. And going back. Over here is another bar. Or is it close? Yeah, now it's close, of course. It's Tuesday afternoon, but it's another bar. There are quite some bars at Marie Heinekenplein. This is what I wanted to show you. This is a really... Oh no, in a controller bar. So sweet when people stop to let me talk. This is a really cool cake shop, quite famous. It is called the Taart van mijn Tante, so my auntie's cake. And look at the cakes that I have. It's so pretty. Look at that. So you can just go inside and look at the cute decor. and just have like hot chocolate and a slice of cake, especially when it's as cold as today. It's a really fun thing to do. More cake. And we're actually going to continue walking over here because I also want to show you a veggie restaurant. I'm vegetarian myself, so if I can help some of my fellow veggies out with a good restaurant recommendation, I'm going to do that. So that's where I'm taking you. Now that we're here, Bakers and Roasters is currently super, super popular for coffee and breakfast. There you go, 8:30 until 4. And they have like eggs and bowls, especially for breakfast. This place is super famous. You should come here. Now we're going to continue walking this way. We're going to go left at the corner, but before we do that, I just wanted to show you this little cute place. It's also very, very extremely cute. Like the very homey feeling decor has been so popular in Amsterdam, and I really, really love it. So see, you can sit there and just feel like you're at home. So cute. Okay, let's go this way into the Frans Halstraat. Left, left, left. And this is the veggie restaurant I wanted to show you. If you're a girl, you can also get a blowout over here at the foam bar. This is the veggie restaurant, the Waaghals. It's organic, vegetarian, and very, very yummy. They have really, really good food. But they're closed now, unfortunately. Just trust me, the food is delicious. And this is a little impression of the neighborhood. Behind, you know, the busy streets. Over here is like a small concept store, but we are going back to the main street, the Ferdinand Bolstraat, right here at the end of the street. I am freezing, by the way. It's so cold. If you come to Amsterdam, seriously, get your warm clothes and layers on layers on layers, because it's really cold. We have arrived at the Ferdinand Bolstraat again. Over here is the dress-up store. And we are going to continue. Where should we go? Well, let's go this way for a little bit, because over here there are also some restaurants and a vintage shop. Over here is like a, well, it's more like a lunch shop. Vintage stuff, if you're into that. You can shop vintage clothes and bags and shoes over here. Amsterdam is really, really good for vintage shopping. Over here we have a music shop. So if you like records, stuff like that. This looks so cute, by the way. A seafood bar, if you're into that. Where should we go? Oh, dim sum. It's like takeout dim sum. And over there, those are also some restaurants. So this one's like steak, burger and karaoke. And over there you have Simple on the other side. It's also very, very cute, and it's quite a tiny restaurant, but they have good food. I like it. Over here is another bar. There are quite some bars in the Pijp area. Over here is just like coffee company. You can have coffee or hot chocolate. Another cafe. And we are going to go this way. Oh, Suriname food. It's also really, really good. Moxie. If you want to go straight to Albert Cuyp, you can just continue straight and go to the left. I have a separate video with a walking tour through the Albert Cuyp. I'm not going to do that today. We are just going to continue this way. Oh, a coffee shop. Okay, so here's a Belgian beer cafe. Gollum. I think this is a famous one, actually. If you guys know that, like Dutch people from Amsterdam or Dutch people in general, let me know down in the comments below, because I think this one is famous. But I don't drink beer, so, you know, I cannot confirm that. Over here, if you want to smoke weed, a coffee shop. And just to be sure, no, I don't smoke weed. I don't smoke in general. I drink maybe like 5 times a year or something. Usually I don't drink at all. So before people start, you know, generalizing, oh, do you smoke weed? No, honey, I don't. I can have a fun time without it. But if you want to, there's a coffee shop over there. I don't judge either. Over here, there's another restaurant. There's another vintage shop. But we are just going to continue straight. Straight, straight, straight. And then we're arriving at this little square. Café Paartje is quite famous. I think it's also quite old. You can have dinner over here, but you can also party over here. Over here is another restaurant. I don't think this is an older famous one, but still. Café Paartje, yeah, you should go there. That's cool. This is also so nice in summer because you can sit outside. Now you can also sit outside, they have heaters, but still in summer it's nicer. And then, should we go here? Let me see. Wait, before I take you this way, I want to show you something else. Okay. Dutch cyclers. This one was a really nice one, actually. Sometimes they just start calling you names and stuff. Okay, we're here, stamppotje. So stamppot is a super traditional Dutch food. It's basically like mashed potatoes with, I think with kale. Yeah, kale is like a super traditional one, boerenkool stamppot. So this place changes to an ice cream shop in summer, and it's called IJskuipje. But in winter, it changes to stamppotje, and you can get the stamppot over here. So this is stamppot. You see that? So mashed potatoes with kale. Sometimes also with spinach or chives. Yeah, but the kale one is a traditional one. So if you want to try something super traditionally Dutch, stamppot. But you do really have to come in winter though, because stamppot is a winter food. We don't eat that in summer. At least, usually we don't. Over here is also a cool coffee shop. So if you would like some more hot chocolate. Let's continue this way. I have to show you some other shops in the street. Another bar where you can party. There's so many bars in this neighborhood. And more seafood. Thrill Grill. These are such good burgers. Okay, I don't eat meat, but really, if you want good burgers, Thrill Grill. It's really nice. And over here we have some concept stores. A small jewelry shop over here. Another coffee shop, you're into that. Another concept store, so this is probably with some interior stuff, home decoration, and also some clothes. It's really a cool neighborhood. Another concept shop, all the luck in the world. Fair concept, probably fair trade and stuff like that. Clothes, shoes. So if you really want to find some cool non-high street brand shops, then this is really the place where you need to be. See? Or, to be very fair, I feel like they all look a little bit alike, but they all have different stuff, of course. Oh, if you need a sofa, you can find it over here. Let me see. Home decoration. Oh my gosh, this is so cute. Cute, cute, cute. Love it. More clothes. Another. Oh, across the street. Do not miss a shop if you're a girl or if you want to buy a girl a gift from Amsterdam. Blond Amsterdam is really a staple brand for, you know, cute. Let me just show you. Cute. I don't know. Mugs and plates and, you know, for baking stuffs. It's so cute. And look at the store. It really looks like a shop in Disneyland. It's really cute. Okay, this is another party shop. This watermelon floaty looks so cute. I like it. Sorry. I was so distracted by that watermelon floaty, I was just bumping into everybody. Over here we have another bar, a cheese shop, and Starbucks. Here, on the left, Foot Locker on the right. We're going to cross the street again this way because I want to show you something else. But there are bagels and beans if you want some bagels, fries. But I would, I don't know if you should get them here. Doesn't matter, all fries in Amsterdam are quite good. Now, continue walking straight. And on the right, you also have like a Surinam place where you can eat. Surinam food is so good, you should really try that. I don't think there are a lot of places outside of Surinam where you can try Surinam food, except in the Netherlands, because it used to be a former Dutch colony. So if you are here, I would highly recommend you to try Surinam food because it's so good, delicious. The thing that I wanted to show you is a little red light district. So of course we have the big red light district in the city center, but there's also a small red light district here in the neighborhood. I'm not sure if I can find it though, so let's just see. Oh, and unfortunately you are never allowed to film the girls. Well, not unfortunately, very fortunately, because it respects the privacy of the girls, but you're never allowed to film them. So that's why if you do see that in a video, it's quite disrespectful towards their privacy, so I would never do that. Going to continue walking straight, trying not to die. And let me see if I can find it. We arrived at the end of the street, and there's also a cool music shop over here. So if you're into music and instruments and stuff like that, you can also, well, maybe buy a guitar here if you like that. I think the red light district is on the left. Let's see. Another bar on the left. If you like bars, seriously, this is your neighborhood. You should just come to the Pijp and go bar hopping. Over here, at this corner, so this is a Sir Albert Hotel, and they have this restaurant called Izakaya. It is a super fancy schmancy sushi place. So if you're looking for a schmancy restaurant in Amsterdam, Izakaya is really good. Let me see. I think the red light district should be somewhere more that way. Should we continue straight? Yeah, let's go. Let's go this way. See, Izakaya. And the red light district is right next to it. So if you, I'm not going to continue walking here or filming, but if you would like to see that, you can just check it out. I'm going to turn around actually and go to the right, because we're going back to the main street, Ferdinand Bolstraat. Around the corner, going straight, going straight. Oh, by the way, Brak is also a good restaurant. There are so many good restaurants in the Pijp. Another bar, it's called Night Sister, so Night Nurse, actually. And another cute lunch shop, so Fenkel means fennel. Local products, lovely salads. Looks so cute. Looks like a salad bar. This way. And nice cycling path. This way, this way. This is what I also wanted to show you, Burgemeester. So I think by now it is quite a famous concept in Amsterdam. It's quite old also. So you can get burgers over here. It's all, I think it's all organic. And they're quite good burgers. It's like, I think it's closed right now, but it's like an American diner. You see that? Yeah, I would also recommend you to eat here. Going to continue straight. More restaurants, an Italian one over here. We have, I think, oh, Korean barbecue over there. What is this? French, I guess. Yeah. So many restaurants, for real. Bakery, fresh handmade donuts over here. Yeah, Korean barbecue. Maos, Israeli food over there. Falafel, actually. And a McDonald's, in case you're a really, really difficult eater and can't find anything. You can also buy some jewelry over here. And then we have arrived at the Albert Cuyp Market over there. I made a separate walking tour video at the Albert Kuip specifically. So if you're interested in seeing that video, the link is down in the description below. This is the end of the Pijp walking tour. I really hope you enjoyed this video and seeing a little bit more of Amsterdam. If you did, please put a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more of my videos, I usually make travel vlogs all around the world. Click that subscribe button and then I will see you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!